With respiratory viral season right around the corner, let's break down the updates to the 2025-2026 COVID-19 vaccine. This vaccine's target is the LP.8.1 SARS-CoV-2 mutation, and these formulations are going to be monovalent, meaning that they're only going to target that specific strain, which is different than a few years ago when they were bivalent, targeting two different strains. There also will be two different types on the market, just like last year, two that are mRNA-based and one that is protein-based. And these are expected to roll out between mid-September to October, depending on the technology type that is used. But regardless of the technology type that is used, let's look at the biochemistry of how these vaccines actually elicit immunity. So if we zoom in on the SARS-CoV-2 LP.8.1 strain, we want to specifically look at that spike protein on the outside of SARS-CoV-2. And those spike proteins have gone through a lot of mutations since they were first identified in 2020. And if we follow the protein-based method, that mutated protein information is going to be grown in culture, therefore accumulating a lot of that mutated spike protein associated with LP.8.1. Then that isolated protein is going to be combined with an adjuvant known as AS01, formulated into a vaccine, and then administered to individuals. Upon administration, our immune system is going to recognize that those mutated proteins don't belong and elicit an immune response in case it comes in contact with that mutated protein in the future on a SARS-CoV-2 virus. It'll know to attack it and protect us. However, if we follow the mRNA-based method, it's very similar. However, we're just moving one step backwards. And that's because we're providing mRNA that is going to code for that mutated spike protein of the LP.8.1 strain. That instructions are going to be encapsulated into a lipid nanoparticle, or LNP. And I've talked about that technology in a previous video, which I'll link in this video's description below. Those LNPs will be formulated into a vaccine, and upon administration, those LNPs will fuse with our cells, delivering the instructions necessary for our cells to then read the instructions and build the mutated spike protein associated with this circulating strain. Upon building that protein, our immune system will recognize that those proteins are not self-proteins, so they'll elicit an immune response, again, allowing us to have some protection in case it comes in contact with that mutated strain during the respiratory viral season. So make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin as we continue covering a broad range of public health topics.